Hello friends, in this video we have to determine whether this system is stable or not, and we have to use the route array logic, and this is the topic from the control system subject. So first point is we have to use the route array logic. So the route array says if we have this equation in left hand side, like in this rows you will write the power of s, start from the highest power of s, and you can see in this equation the highest power is 6. So s to the power 6, and you go up till the lowest power, that is s to power 0. How you will go, that is the next question. But first you have to write the highest power of s, then at the last you should have the lowest power of s. In the highest power of s, the coefficients here should be the even, like whatever the even terms are there, s raised to 6, s raised to 4, s raised to 2, s raised to 0. Whatever the even power of s are present, write the coefficient here. So 1, then we have 8, then we have 20, then we have 16. First point is that. Second point is, after s to power 6, we have s to power 5. Correct? Now, write the odd coefficient here. Which are the odd terms? This, s to power 5, s to power 3, s to power 1. So these are the odd coefficients. So 2, then we have 12, then we have s to the power 1, so the coefficient here is 16, and nothing is present here, so 0. Now how you will find the next term, that is s to power 4? To find that s to power 4, you have to use the formula. The formula says, start from here, 2 into 8 minus 12 into 1 upon 2. So 2 into 8, starting from here, so right to left, then left to right, and upon where you have started, that is 2. So 2 into 8 minus 12 into 1 upon 2, okay, and the answer comes out to be 2 here. So the next coefficient would be 2 into 20 minus 16 into 1 upon 2. So 2 into 20 minus 16 into 1 upon 2, and the answer for here is 12. Then we have the next term. So the third term is 2 into 16 minus 0 into 1 upon 2. So I hope you are getting the flow. So the answer here is 16, and then we have nothing, so the fourth term is 0. Alright, let's take a quick recap. Route array says, first write the highest power of s, that is s to the power 6. If even is present, write the all even coefficient. Like all even coefficient means the all even terms of s, and then their coefficient should be written in the first row. In the second row, the power is decreased from 6 to 5. Now this is odd, so write all odd coefficient from the equation here. Now every term is covered from the equation. Now to get the next term, that is s to power 4, what we have to do, use the formula. What is the formula? Go from left to right, then from right to left upon where you have started. So 2 into 8 minus 12 into 1 upon 2. If you have to find the next term, go in the next column. 2 into 20 minus 16 up into 1 upon 2. You have to find next term, go in the next column, and so on. Alright, I hope you are getting this. So if you have to find the next term, that is s to power 3, how you will find 2? You have to start from here, correct? Then you have to write the coefficient here. What you will do, 2 into 12 minus 12 into 2 upon 2. So what is the answer? 0. Alright, then you have to find this term. So 2 into 16 minus 16 into 2 upon 2. So answer is again 0. Then you have to find the next term. So 2 into 0 into 0 into 2 upon 2. That is again 0. So you are noting that every term, like the every coefficient, is becoming 0. So this is not done, because we have to reach up to s to the power 6, s to the power 0. So this is not done. So next point is, if anywhere between s to power 6 to s to power 0, if you get one row as 0, then you have to use the auxiliary equation logic. So the auxiliary equation says, if s to the power 3 row is becoming 0, take the previous row, that is s to the power 4, and take all the coefficients and write the equation. So how the equation will look like? 2 coefficient, then the highest power is s to the power 4, then we have 12, so plus 12, then this is the even series, so taking the e1 after 4 is h to the power 2. Then we have 16. 16 into h to the power 0. So let's say this is the auxiliary equation A of S. Now take the derivative of that with respect to S. What will happen? 4 into 2, 8. 8 into s to the power 3 plus 2 will come here. So 2 into 12, that is 24 into s to the power 1. And this will go, that is 0. Okay. So this is the equation. So now you can get the terms like the coefficient of s to the power 3. What are the coefficient? First is 8. Then you have 24. Then you have nothing, 0 and 0. Now you have to go to the next part, that is the next row is s to the power 2. Now do again 8 into 12 minus 24 into 2 upon 8. So the answer for this is 6. Then we have to find the next term. So to find the next term, what you have to do? 8 into 16 minus 0 into 2 upon 8. So the answer is 16. And then nothing is there. After 16, the term is 0. So 8 into 0 minus 0 into 2 upon 8 is nothing but 0. So I hope you are getting the flow. Then what is the term of s of 1? So s raised to 1. What would be the coefficients? Let's find that. 6 into 24 minus 16 into 8 upon 6. So the answer for this is 2.67. Then we have 6 into 0 minus 0 into 8 upon 6. That is nothing but 0. And everything would be 0. Then we have s to the power 0, the last. So we started from the highest power, that is s to the power 6, and we went up till the lowest power, s to the power 0. Whenever you get all the rows 0, like in s to the power 3, all the coefficient was the 0. Then what you did? Go for the auxiliary equation. So the previous equation would be your auxiliary equation. Alright, so you written the auxiliary equation. Then what you did? You did the derivative so that you can get the coefficient for the next row, that is s to the power 3. Then after getting that, you solved further for s to the power 2, s to the power 1. Now we are heading for the last row, that is s to the power 0. So 2.67 into 16 minus 0 into 6 upon 2.67. So the answer for this is 16, correct? 16 and 0. Now you know all of this. So how to check whether a system is stable or not? Only check the first column. So if you check the first column, is there any term negative? Answer is no. Is there any term zero? Answer is no. If this is true, then the system is stable. This is as simple as that. So whenever you have to find whether a system is stable or not, and one equation is given, start with the highest power, go up till the lowest power. If any row becomes zero, go for the auxiliary and come back and solve further till you get s to the power 0 term in the last row, correct? And then you have to check the first column. Then you have to ask yourself whether this column has a 0 term or this column has any negative term. If the answer is no, that means your system is stable. Now to check further in the stability, what you have to do, write the auxiliary equation which you have already found, that is 2 into s to the power 4 plus 12 s square plus 16. Then equate this to 0. Then you will get the value of, so let's say s square is equal to y, alright, and you will get now the quadratic equation like this. So 12y plus 16 is equal to 0, and now you will get the value of y, that is equal to minus 3 plus minus 1, that is nothing but you will get the value as minus 2 and minus 4, correct? Then this means that s square is minus 2 and minus 4. This means that you will get the value of s as plus minus j root 2 and plus minus j into 2. Okay, so you have to plot the graph. So this is the graph when we talk about the Laplace domain. Here we have the real part, here we have the imaginary part, and you can see our all poles or all roots are the imaginary, on the imaginary line. So what you have to do is just plot them somewhere here, somewhere here, somewhere here, and somewhere here. So you can see that j root 2 would be here, plus j root 2, minus j root 2 would be here. Then you will have plus j2, so somewhere here, minus j2 somewhere here. So you can note that since we have no repeated roots on j omega, there is no repeated roots. So we can say that the system is stable, but it is marginally stable. Alright, so whenever you solve the stability sum, first check is there any auxiliary equation. If yes, then check whether the system is stable. So if system is stable, then you have to check whether system is marginally stable or not. To check marginally stable, go for the auxiliary equation again and equate that to zero. Okay, then solve this and plot the graph and check whether there are repeated roots or not. If there is no any repeated roots, then you can say that marginally stable.
So friends, agar aapko meri video pasand aa rahi ho, then do like this video, share with your friends and subscribe to my YouTube channel. To milte hain agli video mein. Till then, take care. This is Shrenik Jain. Peace out.